Hello, Dissenters! My name is Italics, and I am here today getting very hungry and Unturned. We're low on food. We're doing a little hunting. There's not a whole lot of things to hunt out here. I've taken a couple pot shots at a nearby moose, and we're continuing to look for it. It's bleeding a little bit, but it's not dead. It takes like 3 shots with a military-grade rifle to take it down, so we're going to use the binoculars to kind of scope things out and look for it. I see a couple zombies, little chef zombie, little sailor zombie, and another Joe Schmo over there not invited to the party. They should really become friends. Anyways, where is that moot? Oh, there he is. I found him grazing innocently with 2 bullet holes, and somewhere up here is where I've got a small structure being built. I see it right there next to a downed helicopter. So we're going to try to make our way back over there after hopefully taking down this moose once and for all. Let's go ahead and go going prone. I cannot aim downwards anymore, so crouch will have to do. Hopefully we hit this moose. Indeed we have. I think that may have been enough to kill him. We got 14 bullets left in this military-grade rifle, so it's probably not a bad idea to try to get some more military-grade rounds from one of the bases or the airport again sometime in the future. But for now, we're going to try to make some room in our inventory for this delicious moose meat, assuming this moose dropped any. Moose can drop a couple different things between meat and skins or pelts, and I believe the pelts can be crafted as well. I am still a complete noob at Unturned as far as crafting goes, so you'll have to forgive me for not knowing the recipes at the moment. Ooh, look, I do have military bullets. I forgot about that. All right, what can we drop and get away with? Probably some moldy corn. I don't want to take any more radiation slash germs, so we're going to drop that and take the raw venison, of which I see 2. And I could take the pelts, but I'm not sure what else I really want to drop right now. There's probably something useless in here, but we're just going to leave that. We can always come back for it later. All right, so now the trick is going to be trying to figure out how to craft a campfire, because we have to be able to cook the venison in order to eat it. And to craft a cook fire, we need some stones as well as some sticks. And we're going to have to hurry because we're at 88% right now. Time is quickly escaping me, guys. We don't have a whole lot of it. We're at 96% on food, 97% on water. We've got water under control, and I'm having to find a boulder, which I only just now discovered. I've been looking around for one of these for a while. I might have even passed one up on the way here. I don't know. I haven't actually mined any stone before, so now I'm showing you how to do it. I think we've broken the rock, and we should have rocks accessible to us, so we have to make this quick. We're dropping all unnecessary things and taking the materials required in order to build a campfire. So now we need to craft the rocks down into stone, but we don't have any room for that either. Okay, Italics, we've only got 3% left, and we've only got 2% on water. We're dropping. Something will be easy to find on the way back here. Let's just drop these wooden plates. I'll come back for them if I need to. Okay, craft. Hurry. Okay, rocks into stone. Ta-da. All right, now we need sticks. We need sticks, Italics. We're at 98%. We don't have time. Equip the axe. We need to chop down a tree. It's really rapid crafting time here on Unturned. Trying to show you guys how to craft as quickly as possible. 98%. We're 99 on water. We're going to start losing health here very soon. I'm going to have to go refill the canteen very quickly. Okay, we've chopped this down. 99% on the water. We can fix that, but we cannot fix 99% on food. Is it full? Is it full? Where'd it go? Drink it! Drink it, Italics! We're losing health! Alright, we got water under control. Now we need to pick up 4 sticks. Can we find 4 sticks in time? There's 1. There's 2. A 3rd stick is here. And a 4th one. Okay, crafting time. Rapid craft. 4 sticks. 4 stones. Equals campfire. Okay, now where's the campfire? Where did it place it in my inventory? Alright, we're at 56% health. We're just gonna have to push it, put that right there. Light it. Alright, don't stand in it or else we're gonna die. Now we need to oh no, I didn't mean to extinguish it. Oh, I'm getting a little nervous. Okay, where's the venison? Here it is. Equip it. I want to, like, place it down there. How do you- is it cooking? I don't know, we're just gonna eat it. I don't know if that's gonna be enough. We only got 10% hunger. And we're still dying. Oh no, I have 100% germs. Italics, you ate raw venison. How do you cook it? How do you cook it, please? Oh, we needed to craft it. We needed to craft it in the fire, and then we needed to place it in here like so, and then we get the cooked venison, and then we craft it, and it's too late. We've succumbed to illness. Why? I didn't know. I didn't know. The day has arrived, and I've got all my stuff back. I found where I died, just like in DayZ. You can recover your lost belongings, assuming someone else does not grab them before you. And I'm noticing that there is a moose here, so why not collect a little bit more venison to supply ourselves with? There's two hits. Can I get a third? Nope, missed a third shot. There is a little bit of bullet deviation. It's not always going to be 100% accurate at range, and I'm sure that'll vary even more based on the weapon at hand. But I picked up my stuff. We're going to head over to Build Island over there, and that's where we're going to continue my little project. Here we are on my lovely island. Let's take a look at the structure which I've built, assuming we don't have to defend it from any zombies that may have respawned. Should be just beyond these trees, kind of close to the helicopter, if I do recall. Yes, there it is. Great. Just a couple wooden beams with one wall. That's as far as I got. Hello, little zombies. Snakes in the grass, slithering up to greet me and welcome me home. So that is the only downside about building next to a helicopter, is that every time you come back, you gotta be prepared to defend it, because more and more of these military zombies. Why is he eating the sandbag? Zombies love sand. Didn't you know that, Italics? That's just kind of zombie 101. We learned that a long time ago. See what we got. Luckily, the loot does respawn around here, so we got a beret, a cot, which we will probably take advantage of. One more zombie. Two more zombies. Oh, I'm out of energy. Okay, so we're going to have to use the quick chop or just use my brand new Uzi in full auto. Oh, Italics, why are you wasting so many bullets? Because it looks amazing. I'm so sorry if you had seizures. I probably should have warned you about that. Safety deposit is going to be in my little base here with just a simple doorway. That's all we've created so far. And just to show you what we have to make here, you have to create the foundation, then each individual pillar, then like a ceiling, and then the walls go in between the pillars. That's kind of how it works. Now these are going to be pretty expensive. It's going to take me a while to grind out the materials. So we're going to start, of course, by chopping down some trees. And we're going to be taking the materials that come out of that, sticks and logs being among them. The more sticks, the better, as they are the rarer of the two for some reason. That doesn't make much sense to me either. Sticks seems like they should be much more prevalent than they are. And now here we go. Okay, try not to embarrass yourself here, Talix. Let us craft the logs first into boards. All right, we might need to dump some more things because we're kind of weighing down. Our travel pack is fairly heavy at the moment, so I might need to drop some more stuff. A gun's pretty heavy, for example, so we don't really need that right now. Anyways, I'm just scared it's going to disappear or something. Alright, so once we have boards, then we craft wooden plates. So I need, I believe, at least two wooden plates for a wooden frame, and then two wooden frames for a wooden wall. Okay, so we're going to craft this twice. Okay, for now. Two wooden supports makes a pillar, and you get supports from sticks. But it looks like I need some more sticks. Like I said, sticks, very difficult to find. I am already getting confused. There's a lot of recipes, guys. It may seem like I'm just being dumb, but there are a lot of recipes. So if you like crafting, you're probably going to have a good time here, because there's a lot of things to make. Ooh. Alright, don't mind me. I'm just trying to craft things. Okay, so it's supports plus boards equals pillars, and we need, what, like, one pillar or two? We're gonna go with two wooden pillars, tentatively. Alright. Two more plates with the boards, and then the plates go with the frame. No, the... I need that. So two wooden frames combined with the pillars equals a wooden wall. Okay, we did it, guys. Whew. Okay, we did it. Now we equip it. Now let me show you how this works. Now I want this base to kind of extend this way, so I'm going to make this into a doorway. So this is going to become a solid wall instead. There we go. We've built a wall. It's pretty cool how you can kind of place it anywhere as long as you have the foundation down pat first. So now... the fun part, making another wooden wall. Here we go. So here's how you're going to go about crafting a foundation and starting this whole process. First, you're going to start with boards. You're going to craft those boards down into plates. Then you're going to craft enough plates into three wooden frames. And then you're going to get a wooden foundation. And from there, you should be able to equip it and decide where it is going to go. Now, I've never attempted to combine more than one foundation. So it would be cool if it could kind of auto-lock onto it, but instead I'm having to kind of just guess where it should go. And I feel like if I move a little over and a little closer, this is probably about as good as it's going to get. There we go. You know, I was fairly close. I was a little off. But I think once you get some walls and some pillars down, you're not really going to be able to tell the difference. And from here on out, we now have a mostly enclosed small base. I know we still need some doors, and as a result, we're going to figure out how to craft them, of course. We need a wooden frame and bolts. So unfortunately, I do not have any bolts, so we're just going to have to kind of leave it as is. The supports plus the board equals the pillars, and that's three pillars, and we're going to equip the pillars. Why can't... Oh, there we go. Okay, they're turning green. Put these down. There's two. Oh, no. Italics, what have you done? What have you done? You built this far too close. You were trying to make a house, and I think you failed because you can't clip into the other building. Well, do you see this? It's connecting. So we're just going to do this for now, and there's like a sneaky side entrance in here. We're going to have to make a door there. I'm sorry for this lack of foresight. I didn't know that the ramp was going to look like this, but you can get up here and make yourself some barricades and some sandbags and use this as a lookout and snipe people from afar. That sounds pretty awesome to me. All right, so we've done some crafting. I've shown you some of the things that you can make. Please keep in mind there is a lot more that I have no idea how to make and that I'd have to grind a lot for, including things like windows and doors, which I could craft if I had bolts, etc. You get the idea. But just know that it is a pretty deep crafting system and there's a lot to work on here. One wooden pillar creates two wooden posts. What is a wooden post precisely? You can just place this down wherever you want to, or it goes on top of the pillars. It's like decoration or ooh, fancified. Italics likey. That looks pretty nice. And then you could probably make some kind of fence or small wall in between those. There's a lot of options here for reals. Supports plus board equals pillar. All right, so two pillars plus frames equals wall. And then wall breaks down into ramparts. And then ramparts can be equipped, yes, as a low-lying wall in order to give you some cover. Glorious. How cool is that?
So you're taking cover here. This guy's way out there in the distance. Oh, snipe him.
So if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more Unturned videos like it in the future with some more crafting or perhaps some more zombie slang looting or just some multiplayer online me getting stomped, let me know by leaving a like on the videos that you enjoy. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.